So the new album is called Year of / The Bear. It was really kind of a two-part effort, right, Kurt?
Yeah, that's right. We had two EPs released on the same date in consecutive years, and a little bit of a sad story, but it's a tribute to a friend of mine who passed away on that day a couple years ago.
Who was that?
Well, his nickname was The Bear. I'll leave his real name out of it for privacy. But just a close friend of mine, and the album is sort of a tribute to the time that I had with him, you know, knowing that his passing was imminent. He had cancer, so this was a way to kind of honor him and do it in an extended period rather than just one recording that comes out and then fades away. I got to sort of make a journey out of it.
Were the songs about him at all, or
indirectly?
Indirectly, yeah.
Not about him, but it's more about some of the thoughts and the feelings that I had during that time, and some of his as well. So
yeah. Now, you told me recently that you're back in Louisville. Where have you been?
Oh, well, this will need more than 5 minutes.
That's okay.
So I have a business in Berlin, so I spend a good part of my year there. And then I try to get back to Louisville for usually around 1 or 2 months out of the year. And this happens to be that stint. And I have these guys, you know, making me look good. So it's a nice treat when I come here to play with them.
Yeah, when I was reading up on you a little bit, I found an interview of you on a radio station in Malta. So yeah. I was like, well, this is unusual.
Yeah, that's part of the more than the 5 minutes that we need. I spent about 6 months in Malta sort of working on a branch of my business there.
Yeah.
It's a beautiful country. A lot of people here may not know about it. It's a tiny, beautiful island in the Mediterranean, one of the smallest countries in the world, and stunning.
Yeah. So may I ask what your business is outside of music?
Yeah, my business is I help European people improve their English quickly, so it through language immersion. So I basically get native speakers, like most or all of us, together with people who speak English as a second, third, or fourth language, and sort of hold, it's almost like a summer camp. It's a chance for them to practice 10, 12, 14 hours a day. But what it really is just a chance to all hang out and sort of share philosophies and under the guise of a language immersion program.
So that sounds really cool.
They have no idea. They figure out the trick on day one, but they think they're coming for a language course. It works out well.
Tell us about where you recorded this. Did you record some of this overseas then?
Yes. Some of the drums were recorded in Berlin. Nick was there for some of that time. That was quite a situation. We recorded in some old sort of communist loft building, you know. It was a whole situation. And then drums and guitars. I'll take this opportunity to mention Dylan Stoddard and Frank Cueto. They were involved in the recording heavily on the production side. So I recorded, some of the other things with Dylan. And Dylan also plays bass and some other instruments on the record as well. So it's been a collaboration all throughout.
Any recording in Louisville?
No, not on this particular recording, but I'd like to fix that. And I think I got some people around me that could help. So
you certainly do. You got some stellar musicians with you today. Would you mind introducing
who
we have here?
We got Rory Hanka on the keys.
All right.
Yeah, he and I have been playing together for a while now. Yeah. And this is Nick Goldring on the drums and soon to be guitar in just a moment. And we got Ryan Scott on the bass.
Excellent. And now
the Watchdogs.
a lot of these guys have played with Quiet Hollers too over the years.
This stage is a who's who of Louisville bands. I think if you did the math, I did it right before I came up. It's 27.5% of the bands in Louisville have either had or have one of these musicians in it.
Yeah.
27.5.
Well, you are getting ready to make a switch to the drums. Drums were your first instrument, right? Or
yeah, my dad had a dad band, and he got a drum set, and he made the mistake of putting it in the attic. So then when the drummers always quit, I was the only one that could play. So I've been playing in, dad band since I was, 12 or 13. I was always the fill-in when the guy didn't show up to rehearsal. So that was my first love there.
Yeah, and when did you switch to guitar?
Well, some people say I haven't. I mean, you heard it. You were here. I use instruments with notes primarily for writing. You know, I wouldn't claim the guitar. I enjoy playing it, but drums is probably my, you know, well, I'm putting a lot of pressure on myself. I can't go stink it up now on the drum set. But yeah, guitar is something that came later. I probably didn't touch a guitar until I was 19 or 20, actually.
Wow. Yeah, that's a little late to the game these days, isn't it?
Yeah.
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 Well, I would never know that, just as a listener. I think it sounds great. Well, how about we let you get back to it? And I think you're gonna play some drums now, right?
I guess so.
All right.
See how it goes.
Well, Kurt Reifler and the Watchdogs again. The new album's called Year of the Bear.